Hi. So, as I said, I will be doing some exercise. Let's start by the first one, which will be a reinforced concrete design of a two-dimensional frame. I have already highlighted the most important steps here. So, but first of all, let's make this one here. I've already opened the program. More. Now we have to select the projects. I'm going to pick this one. Frame 2D design. Going to close the tips and close this. Now, let's start by the axis definition. Next step, position 0, number of positions 4, distance 6, and this is the numbering. Okay. Z 3 ABC. 3 3 ABC add apply. There we go. There we have our structural axis. Now it's time to, as you may see in this picture, now it's time to define the beams and the columns. Let's go here. We have already the column defined. Okay. The beam. We can also define the section here. I don't have the section that I want available because this is the cross-sectional area. I do not have it available, so I'm going to make it. Press this button. Now 45. 60. Section type reinforced concrete beam. Okay. Now, let's define the columns, should be a reinforced concrete column that goes from here to here and goes from here to here. Let's close this. Now we can copy as this step here suggests. Control A to select all, edit, move or copy, number of copies 4. Let's go back here and define the translation vector as from this point to this point. There we have all of our columns already defined. Now let's define the beams, or at least a reinforced concrete beam. Like this, reinforced concrete beam. I have to tell the program which is the bar type because later I will want to design these elements and the program needs to know which is the bar type to pick the right choices for the design. Normally, a reinforced concrete beam has a scheme of reinforcement different from a column. Let's pick this point, this point. I can press drag, so I can click it once here and here and finally here. Close this, also close this. I'm sorry. We already have the reinforced concrete elements defined, as it shows here in this picture. Now we will insert the truss from the library. I'll select the library icon. Okay, select here. It's loading. Double click here. And first of all, the length of the truss will be 24 meters. Truss length. The height will be 3 meters. Truss height. And the number of fields will be 12. It finds the number of fields into which the truss will be divided. Okay. Let's do it. 24, 3, 12. Okay, next step, I have to click on the insert, more sections. No, we need to define the sections. To all truss shorts, upper and lower, we have to assign this one here. 90 by 10, okay. Let's go upper short. This is the database. The database is correct. Click here. 90 by 10. Okay. Now I can copy this and paste it here. Upper and lower short. And for the diagonals, I have to assign this section over here. Okay. Let's go then. Pick this here, yeah, there, 70 by 7, okay. Now I have to insert my triangular truss type 1. It's how, it is how the library is identifying this, okay. We go back to the steps. Left mouse click on the insertion point field, select the node number 3. No, not available insertion point. We'll have the following coordinates, 0, 0, and 6. And this defines the truss beginning node. 6. Now, I'll have to press apply. I can see down here that it went well. And I can press OK. And there we have our structures. I can see the numbering is perfectly well. So now we'll have to define a release, as you may see here. Let me zoom this just a bit. Left mouse click on the selection field. Okay. Select the truss bar. Attention. Take note of the arrows that appear on the highlight truss bar. While indicating the bar, the arrows should be pointing up the direction out, but the release is significant. At the first node, the pinned connection remains, whereas at the second node, the fixed connection is defined. Okay, I'm going to explain this. We have to make a release on this bar over here. Let's turn off the section shape. Geometry, releases. I'm going to pick a pinned fixed release, as you may see here. Pinned fixed release. The arrow should be pointed up. What this means is just this. I have picked a pinned fixed release, which means the first node will be pinned, the second node will be fixed. If the arrows are pointing up like they do right now, as you may see here, the one which will be pinned it will be this one, and the one which will be fixed, it will be this one. If the arrows were down in the downwards direction, the one which will be pinned, it was this node here, and the one fixed, it will be this one here. That's what they are trying to explain here. So pinned fixed up. I got this one pinned and this one fixed. Down, I got this one pinned and this one fixed. I want this way. Okay, now I can close it. Zoom on the structure. Now we have to define fixed supports. Okay, pick the supports. Fixed, current selection are all of these nodes. And apply. Okay. We made it. We have mounted the geometry. This is planar geometry. You may see the structure that we have defined here in a perspective. Just click this little funny house over here. Okay. You can also turn down the representation of the structural grid. Just go to display, structural axis, and turn them off. Apply. Okay. Turn off the numbering of the nodes, and you may ask the program to make to mark with colors the sections. The legend will be by colors. You may see here. This green will be the section over here, as you may see. This blue will be the concrete column, and this will be the concrete beam. I'm running out of time. This is the part one of the movie. We'll have to do much more to end. So thank you for watching, and please subscribe.